Imagine this. 10,000 years from now, an explorer wanders a forgotten land, searching for traces of a lost civilization. They begin to dig among some odd, unsettling-looking ruins, and as they dig, they unearth a mysterious granite disc, not quite 2 hands wide, covered in unnatural markings. It's the find of the century, at least until the explorer starts getting sick. And so does everyone else who decided it was worth setting up a permanent dig site to learn more about the people who left that plate behind. The land, it turns out, was cursed by that lost civilization, and the plate was their attempt at a warning for future generations to stay away. If only their message had been understood. That scenario might seem theatrical, but it isn't just fiction. Because right now, in the southeast corner of New Mexico, the United States is burying decades of nuclear waste. The site will remain deadly for millennia. So scientists are trying to figure out how to keep people from disturbing the area long, long after we're gone. If you drive about 40 minutes east of Carlsbad, New Mexico, you'll find yourself at the Waste Isolation Pilot Plant, or WIP. And the waste it's isolating is nuclear. It isn't made up of glowing green barrels, though. It's much less dangerous-looking stuff. Clothes, tools, rags, debris, residues, and other non-liquid disposable items. But they're all contaminated with radioactive elements like plutonium, and many versions of these elements have really long half-lives, meaning that they take forever to decay. According to one estimate, the waste being stored at the WIP will remain lethal for 300,000 years, which is way longer than the goal of crafting a message that will last 10,000 years, but that's a hard enough challenge as it is. Because 10,000 years is plenty of time for Earth's civilizations and cultures to become utterly unrecognizable. Just take a look at where we are now. If you could travel that far back in time, you'd find yourself in the late Stone Age. Humans were still figuring out agriculture and animal domestication and hadn't yet developed writing. So the WIP team's crafting of the ultimate keep out sign has been in progress for decades, bringing together material scientists, archaeologists, linguists, anthropologists, even science fiction writers. The messages they're working on are called passive institutions controls, or PICs, and there are several hurdles to overcome. First, you have to consider the limitations of whatever you'll store your message on. Stone erodes, wood and paper can burn and rot, metals could get scrapped and reused for more important projects, and so on. Meanwhile, you can basically forget about electronic media altogether. Your average solid-state drive only has a lifespan of about 10 years these days, and when those fail, the data on them is essentially gone. Even the most durable compact discs only last a century before they start to fail. One medium you may not have thought of, but archaeologists know can last more than 10,000 years, is bone. Discovered in 1950 in what's now the Democratic Republic of Congo, the Ishango bone dates back to the Upper Paleolithic era, about 20,000 years ago. It's a simple bone tool, perhaps from a baboon, covered in columns of grouped tally marks. But exactly what those marks mean, no one knows. Researchers have proposed a bunch of ideas for what this bone was used for, from some kind of calculator to a calendar. We'll be getting back to the problem of interpretation later, but the WIP doesn't have to rely on a bunch of bones or anything similarly old school to get its message across. Researchers are working on new methods of long-term storage. For example, one team based at MIT has been working to store digital information in DNA. They've tested the technique by encoding the Emancipation Proclamation, the MIT logo, and even the Jurassic Park theme song. And while DNA molecules do degrade over time, this research team has developed a method to store them in a special block of silica, taking inspiration from the millennia-long preservation of DNA in amber. Of course, DNA has the same problems as CDs and Betamax tapes. Future civilizations will also have to know how to decode a string of ones and zeros, or DNA nucleobases, into the messages we're actually trying to send them. But this hasn't stopped us from recording such encoded messages for our distant descendants. Back in 2007, NASA's Phoenix lander was sent to Mars with a miniature DVD made of etched silica. And an even more extreme version of this project, featuring an etched diamond wafer, was planned for the Cassini mission to Saturn. The messages on that diamond were meant to last billions of years, up until the sun turns into a red giant and may or may not eat the Earth. Unfortunately, the plan fell through because the project's funder, Fuji Xerox, wanted the company's logo to be included on the diamond. But fun fact, some of the researchers involved in that project were involved with both the Phoenix time capsule and the WIP. According to the Department of Energy, the WIP's current plans call not for a diamond wafer or a silica DVD, but a batch of 23 centimeter wide disks made from granite, aluminum oxide, or fired clay, just in case one material winds up standing the test of time better. The disks will be scattered around the site and buried at just the right depth, so they'll stay put for millennia, but can still be dug up by people who need the warning. There are also plans to construct whole archive buildings, as well as separate monuments, all out of granite. That hopefully solves the longevity problem, and they're choosing to evade that pesky decoding problem. But there's still the issue of how future humans are going to understand the warning that's written down. But before I tell you how they plan to solve that, a quick ad.
Thank you to McLaren Stanley, Charlie Stanley, and TJ Stein for your continued support of trustworthy stuff that inspires curiosity and lowers barriers to knowledge building. These incredible patrons help us keep SciShow totally free for everybody else. Unless you are also a patron, in which case, thank you. You are also doing that. And if you want to check out our Patreon and see what you can responsibly give, it's patreon.com/SciShow. That money goes toward cultivating curiosity and building knowledge in every way we can. It goes toward supporting this team of amazing people who I love to work with. That said, it doesn't cost a thing to keep watching SciShow.
Consider how hard English teachers have it getting students to understand what Shakespeare wrote. Shakespeare died in 1616, 4 centuries ago. That's only 4% of the 10,000 years the WIP team is planning for. And he was writing in early modern English. Actual old English sounds like this. What way gardena in yer de gum ye frunon? Did you catch that? I didn't. It's from the opening of Beowulf, an epic poem written around 1200 years ago. It translates to, "Lo, we have heard of spear Danes in the days of yore," which some of you will argue is still not modern English. Some languages do shift more slowly than others, like Icelandic, Lithuanian, or Tamil, but even those languages will change significantly over 10,000 years. Linguists only know of one language that dates back 10,000 years, Proto-Afroasiatic. This language is the ancestor of modern-day languages like Arabic, Hausa, and Somali, and it's estimated to be anywhere from 10 to 20,000 years old. But unfortunately, we can't understand it very well. It hasn't been reconstructed to the same degree as other ancient languages, and many scholars still disagree over basic things about it. But they are working on it, which means that it's possible scholars 10 millennia from now could understand one of our languages if they put the effort in. The WIP warnings will be written in 7 different languages to hedge their bets. English, French, Spanish, Arabic, Russian, Chinese, and because it's in the American Southwest, Navajo. But what should we write in all of those languages? How much detail should we include? In 1993, a group from Sandia National Laboratories in New Mexico put together a report dividing messages into 4 levels, which could be used to warn visitors with increasing levels of complexity. After all, messages with more detail are more difficult to understand, but messages with lower levels of detail and nuance might not convey enough information. But together, they would convey a unified message. This is not a place of honor. No highly esteemed deed is commemorated here. Nothing valued is here. What is here is dangerous and repulsive to us. The danger is still present in your time as it was in ours. This place is best shunned and left uninhabited. For level 1, the WIP team plans on using hostile architecture just to make it obvious that the site is not completely natural. Humans were here and did something. That hopefully will get our distant descendants to stop and pay attention long enough to see the other messages, carved either into the discs or a much larger information archive buried on site. Then the level 2 messages kick in, simply to tell people that there's something dangerous buried below the surface. At the moment, the plan is to use both text and pictographs, like symbols showing a human face recoiling in horror. The level 3 messages will expand on that, telling people that the danger is radioactive and that they shouldn't dig or drill. Basic who, what, when, where, why stuff. They'll also include a map of the site and charts of the stars showing both the time when the site was sealed and when it should be safe again, because we can't assume they'll be familiar with our calendar system that far in the future.
And we right now can predict where the stars will be in the sky 10,000 years from now pretty easy.
and they'll instruct people to add their own translations in the empty space provided to make it easier for people in the even more distant future to understand the warning. Finally, level 4 messages will have the most detail, like full-blown essays that talk about stuff like cancer being the primary thing you have to worry about, and why we chose to bury all this nuclear waste in this particular spot. This level will also include a map of the world with markers for the locations of other nuclear waste disposal sites, so that future scholars could go and make sure that the warning messages there are intact and readable. It's a lot to think about. But you might also be wondering why we're bothering with language at all. Can't we just draw symbols to get our point across? Well, the WIP team has thought of that. They might not be as vague as tally marks, but symbols aren't universal across cultures and times either. Take the skull and crossbones. While we interpret that to mean danger, pirate or otherwise, in the Middle Ages it was used to represent Adam's skull and Christ's cross. That said, there are other ways to convey meaning through time. Our society is full of ideas that descend from oral history and tradition, going far back enough that we've forgotten the meaning. One particularly out there idea proposed by a consultant back in the 80s includes starting a new religion, or as he referred to it, an atomic priesthood. Even if it died out, its myths might remain. Then again, he also pointed out that the threat of curses didn't exactly prevent grave robbing in Egypt, so it might not be the best plan to enact. Still, oral history is a legitimate technique that's been used by humans to pass knowledge down across millennia. We even have examples of Australian Aboriginal stories recounting a rise in sea level that happened over 7,000 years ago. Some stories might be as old as 13,000 years, which is beyond the timeline the WIP is planning for. So humans have a lot of options to communicate with the distant future, each with their own complications. That might explain why planning these nuclear waste picks has taken decades. Back in 2004, researchers said that they wanted to have the WIP's messages finalized by 2033, but it's been difficult to find any official updates after 2007. The WIP site itself was supposed to be sealed in 2020, but that hasn't happened yet. It's been plagued with setbacks like a radiation leak in 2014 that may have affected some staff and caused the site to close for 3 years. But eventually the WIP site will close, and hopefully 10,000 years from now, that explorer will figure out the land isn't actually cursed, but they should still hold off on setting up that dig site.